Hey, everybody, and welcome to Backyard Horsemanship, and we are continuing our little tech talk extravaganza, the fun stuff that we're doing here. We're continuing to talk about La Bozal, La Jaquima, La Macate, M-E-C-A-T-E, B-O-S-A-L, J-A-Q-U-I-M-A. I'm not really, really all that great at Spanish either, so, I mean, hang in there with me. My pronunciations are probably ridiculously off, but that's how I learned to pronounce them, so, you know, it is what it is. Talking about La Bozal, and I'm just going to go ahead and bang everything into my camera tripod here, so you just bear with me. When La Bozal is sitting on the nose of the horse, and that as part of the whole Jaquima, one of the things that you're going to want to pay attention to in specific is the balance point of the knot at the bottom. The knot at the bottom is actually going to, as you pull up on the rein and pull back, if I was on a horse and I was pulling back on the rein on one side, remember we don't pull on two reins. We stop our hands occasionally, but we don't pull on two reins. We don't go like that. We pull on one rein. When we pull it back on one rein, what happens? You can see it happening right now. It turns the top. What that does is it engages this side piece in the face. Now, a traditional side pull that you would use, and people often consider a hackamore, a traditional side pull will actually pull more directly on the whole side of the face of the horse. It is a true lateral flexion device, all right? And there are some people that like them and some people that hate their guts. A rope hackamore is somewhat similar because instead of pulling from the side on a rope hackamore, you have more of a of the same effect as you have when you pull the rein on a Jaquima, you have more of the effect of you get your pull from the bottom. The problem is that there's more conforming of the shape of the rope to the side of the horse's face. So there's the pressure is really more widely applied. Whereas with La Jaquima, bear in mind that that pressure as it is pulled is going to be applied this way. It's going to tilt. So what it's going to actually do is two kind of things. And this is just from my experience. So I'm pretty sure that there's a lot more going on there. And if you do a little research, you'll find it. Okay? I found quite a bit by, you know, using them on my horses and just trying to do myself a favor and have soft hands. It's the other part. Always have soft hands. As this tilts, as you pull on the rein and you draw it back to you, it tilts in to the horse's chest and down. So what ends up happening is you get a tilt like this to pull for a right hand. On a horse that is pushing, if you put your fingers aside your nose, like you're going to give yourself a big old farmer blow, well, you put that pressure there. What happens is, as you're pushing down, you actually have a downward push and a sideward push at the same time. So what it's doing is it's encouraging the horse to a degree to break at the pole and to turn their head, whichever direction it is that they're turning. So to a degree, by nature of its design, La Jaquima is designed to also begin to introduce the beginning stages of vertical flexion, breaking at the pole, broadening of the neck, shortening of the back, and the driving under, with your driving aids, of course, engaged, also driving underneath of the horse. So you're not going to get some really beautiful dressage perfection there, but it is going to introduce that feel that when you turn, I want you to bring your nose in and around. I want a compacted, collected turn. I want strength. I want the capability of moving out in a very quick fashion. So if I'm here, sitting here and I'm going to my left and I'm shooting off this way, if I've got my horse all strung out, his balance point is going to be way off to my left. And that's really no good. What I want my horse to do is start to think slowly about collecting myself in on the turns. Yes, I'm following my nose, and yes, I'm moving right and I'm moving left as the correct rein is applied, and as the correct leg in and seat aids are applied. But what ends up happening is that I also am encouraging my horse ever so slightly to introduce some vertical flexion. So he breaks at the pole, brings his nose in and comes around. What that's going to do is also, if I'm doing it correctly and timing it right with my seat aids, is going to bring my horse underneath of himself, especially if, as I'm making this left-hand turn and that horse's nose is coming over and in, if my leg, my outside leg, is driving my shoulder over, my inside leg and seat has to pick up at the correct time my inside left hind leg. So I'm going to be picking up that horse's inside left leg and putting it in place. And I'm going to be driving it a little bit deeper, and that's where your seat comes in. You ask for a little more, for a little broader step on the inside to drive deeply into that. And of course, that's also where you start working on your lead changes and things of that nature, your lead departures. It all sort of begins. Your horse has to, number one, know how to follow his nose. No horse goes anywhere if his nose is going up in the air that way, willingly, happily, and in a healthy, athletic manner. I've seen a lot of horses with their heads bent around to their butts that are, you know, hell-bent for leather for the hills, all right? That's not to say that it doesn't happen, but healthy, happy, athletic movement starts with bringing the horse's nose in. Later on, when La Jaquima is completely and thoroughly understood by the horse, and this could take a number of years before the horse is going super soft, and you won't even see what that rider is doing with those reins. You'll be like, how did that horse know to turn left? Well, it's all the aids that the rider's applying, and the horse is really soft. What they will do is put La Bozalito. No, La Bozalito is a very small, it's something called a pencil bozal. It's a very small, thin bozal, and they will that will come in place after the horse is packed a bit around with La Bozal in La Jaquima for any length of time until the horseman deems the horse is ready for La Bozalito. When La Bozalito is put across the horse's nose, it's obviously you're in a two-rein situation. You've got reins attached to that curb bit, and you've got reins attached to La Bozalito, and so your timing comes with your first request is with the reins, and La Bozalito supports it. Now, everybody thinks that La Bozalito, because it's so thin, is a very harsh, harsh piece. You know, it's just like a thin piece of string that goes over a horse's nose. Oh, my gosh, that's got to be terribly harsh. It's only harsh as the hands that are using it and the lack of training that is involved in the horse that is being used on. So, remember, softness is encouraged in small little bits. That's why training a horse, it's not something that you can say, oh, well, this horse is finished in 3 to 4 years. Horses are never finished in 3 to 4 years. Horses aren't finished in 25 years. They are always growing, just as your horsemanship is always growing. So, that's the basics of how La Bozal and La Jaquima work together along with La Macate. And that's just fun to say, isn't it? La Bozal, La Bozal. I love this. It's marvelous. That's how those work together to start the transition and the training of a horse from Jaquima to Freno. From my understanding, if you would like to learn more about that, I'm sure you can go to Ed Connell's website. You can Google Ed Connell or Ernie Morris. Ernie Morris is a fantastic one. Ed Connell was the gentleman that wrote Hackmore Reinsman and of the West. Anyway, go to the website, just Google them, and find them and get some great information. And hey, I'll see you out on those trails.